नमस्कार दोस्तों, आप सभी का स्वागत है GPATINDIA.com के YouTube चैनल पर। आज हम लर्न करेंगे डिसइंफेक्टेंट्स के क्वेश्चंस जो रेगुलरली एग्जाम्स के अंदर पूछे जाते हैं, MCQ, वो MCQ और वो पॉइंट्स जिन पर कि रेगुलरली क्वेश्चंस पूछे गए हैं, जैसे कि NEET PG एग्ज़ाम हो गया, GPAT हो गया, GATE लाइफ साइंसेज हो गया, CSIR UGC NET लाइफ साइंसेज हो गया, फार्मासिस्ट रिक्रूटमेंट एग्ज़ाम हो गया, ड्रग इंस्पेक्टर रिक्रूटमेंट एग्ज़ाम एंड पैरामेडिकल स्टाफ रिक्रूटमेंट एग्ज़ाम एज वेल एज सैनिटरी इंस्पेक्टर रिक्रूटमेंट एग्ज़ाम्स। सो इन सभी पर डिसइंफेक्टेंट चैप्टर में से कौन कौन से सेक्शन से क्वेश्चन पूछे जाते हैं वो हम देखने का प्रयास करेंगे। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज एंडोस्कोप इज स्टरलाइज्ड बाय ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड, फॉर्मल्डिहाइड, ऑटोक्लेविंग एंड हॉट एयर ओवन। सो बेसिकली एंडोस्कोप इज अ इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट आर बेस्ट स्टरलाइज बाय 2% ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड और ऑर्थो ऑप्थेल्डिहाइड। सो द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड इज द करेक्ट आंसर। सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज प्रियोन्स आर बेस्ट किल्ड बाय ऑटोक्लेविंग एट 121 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, 5% फॉर्मेलिन। थर्ड वन इज सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड फॉर 1 आवर, सोडियम हाइपोक्लोराइट फॉर 10 मिनट्स। सो बेसिकली प्रियोन्स आर स्टरलाइज बाई 0.5% हाइपोक्लोराइट फॉर 2 आवर्स और 1 NaOH फॉर 1 आवर और बाय ऑटोक्लेविंग फॉर 134 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड फॉर 1 to 1.5 आवर्स। सो हियर द बेस्ट ऑप्शन गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन इज सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड फॉर 1 आवर। सो दिस वन इज द करेक्ट आंसर। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट डिसइंफेक्टेंट्स ऑल आर ट्रू एक्सेप्ट। ये क्वेश्चन पूछा गया है पहले गेट एग्जामिनेशंस में एज वेल एज एम्स में 2011 में। सो द ऑप्शंस आर हाइपोक्लोराइड इज वायरुसाइडल, ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड इज स्पोरिसाइडल, फिनॉल कैन एक्ट इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल, इथेनॉल कैन नॉट किल माइकोबैक्टीरिया। सो देखिए इसमें हम देखते हैं कि कौन कौन से जो ऑप्शन मीन्स स्टेटमेंट्स दिए हैं वो ट्रू हैं और कौन कौन से ट्रू नहीं हैं। सो देखिए इथेनॉल एक्ट वेल अगेंस्ट बैक्टीरिया एंड माइकोबैक्टीरिया बट हैज़ अ पुअर एक्शन अगेंस्ट वायरसेस एंड स्पोर्स। ओके सो एंड इन द क्वेश्चन द स्टेटमेंट इज गिवन इथेनॉल कैन नॉट किल माइकोबैक्टीरिया, हाउएवर इथेनॉल एक्ट एज अ वेल अगेंस्ट बैक्टीरिया एंड माइकोबैक्टीरिया। सो दिस ऑप्शन इज द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन। नाउ टेकिंग द अदर ऑप्शंस लाइक फिनॉल कैन एक्ट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल, यस फिनॉल डिसइंफेक्टेंट कैन एक्ट रेडिली इवन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक मटेरियल विदाउट गेटिंग इनएक्टिवेटेड एंड ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड इज ऑल्सो अ स्पोरिसाइडल एजेंट एंड हाइपोक्लोराइड इज एक्टिव अगेंस्ट ग्राम पॉजिटिव, ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया, वायरसेज इंक्लूडिंग HIV, HBV, हाउएवर दे आर लेस एक्टिव अगेंस्ट माइकोबैक्टीरिया। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज स्टरलाइजेशन ऑफ फाइबर ऑप्टिक इज डन बाय, एंड दिस क्वेश्चन इज आज इन एम्स नवंबर 2003 एग्जाम एंड DNB डिसंबर 2012 एग्जाम। सो द ऑप्शंस गिवन आर ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड, क्लोरीन, ऑटोक्लेव एंड फिनॉल। सो द फाइबर ऑप्टिक इज अ फ्लेक्सिबल ट्रांसपेरेंट फाइबर मेड ऑफ हाई क्वालिटी एक्सट्रूडेड ग्लास, सिलिका और प्लास्टिक यूज फॉर लेरिंजोस्कोप। सो फाइबर ऑप्टिक लेरिंजियोस आर बेस्ट स्टरलाइज बाय ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड और ऑर्थो ऑप्थेल्डिहाइड। सो द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ग्लूटेरिल्डिहाइड। नेक्स्ट वन इज विच इज द फॉल्स अबाउट स्प्लूडिंग क्लासिफिकेशन। सो नॉन क्रिटिकल आइटम आल्सो इंक्लूड इन द क्लासिफिकेशन, सेमी क्रिटिकल आइटम कॉन्टैक्ट विद म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन, semi-critical item needs load and disinfectant and cardiac catheter examples critical items. So the correct answer is semi-critical items need low disinfectants are in included in the this classification. So semi-critical item are those that come in contact with mucous membrane or minor skin breaches, and they need high to intermediate level disinfectant for sterilization. Next one is, which of the following statement regarding disinfectant is not true? देखिए यहाँ क्वेश्चन में ध्यान देने वाली बात है कि यहाँ पर पूछा गया है कि कौन सा स्टेटमेंट ट्रू नहीं है, नॉट ट्रू. तो एग्जामिनर बहुत सी बार इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस भी देता है जहाँ पर थोड़ा सा उसको सेंटेंस को घुमाया जाता है. तो फर्स्ट ऑप्शन, यहाँ हमको सारे देखना होगा कि कौन कौन से स्टेटमेंट ट्रू नहीं है, मीन्स फॉल्स है. सो हाइपोक्लोराइड्स आर बैक्टीरियाइडल एंड इनएक्टिवेटेड बाय ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. Glutaraldehyde is sporicidal and not inactivated by organic matter. Formaldehyde is bactericidal, sporicidal and virucidal. Phenol is bactericidal, rapidly inactivated by organic matter. Now looking on every options, so the first option they given is the correct, because chlorine and hypochlorites are markedly bactericidal, virucidals. And their disadvantage is they are ineffective if used at alkaline pH, and less effective in presence of organic matter, relatively unstable in if exposed to sunlight. And option B, glutaraldehyde, this is option is also correct. Glutaraldehyde is sporicidal and not inactivated by organic matter, especially effective against tubercular bacilli, fungi, viruses, less toxic and irritant to eye, skin and then formaldehyde. Then looking on the third option, formaldehyde is bactericidal, sporicidal and virucidal. It is used for sterilizing instrument and heat sensitive catheters. Formaldehyde gas is used for operation theater fumigation. Next option is that is phenol is active against wide range of microorganisms. They are not inactivated by presence of organic matter. So this option is incorrect. So the correct answer is fourth. D option is the correct answer for this question. Now next one is phenol coefficient indicate. This question is asked so many times in various examinations like GPAT, GAT, UGC, CSIR, UGC, NET, Chipman, as well as so many other examinations. So the options are efficacy of a disinfectant, dilution of a disinfectant, quantity of a disinfectant and purity of a disinfectant. So basically testing efficacy of disinfectant by phenol coefficient. This is also known as a Rieder-Walker test. Phenol coefficient is determined by the dilution of the disinfectant which sterilizes the suspension of Salmonella typhi in a given time divided by the dilution of the phenol which sterilizes the suspension of in the same time. Okay. Next one is, which disinfectant work by plasma membrane damage? This question is also asked in previously GATE Pharmaceuticals and GPAT as well as GNB June 2011. So question is asked on the disinfectant work by plasma membrane damage. So here examiner asking about the mechanism of action. So we have to learn about the various agent by which mechanism they are acting for their disinfectant action. So alcohol, metallic salt, phenol, halogen compounds. So alcohol basically act by coagulation of bacterial protein. Metallic salt act by protein coagulation and removal of free sulfur hydryl group. Phenol are act by disruption of cell membrane at high concentration and inactivate enzyme and precipitate protein at low temperature. And halogen compounds oxidation and removal of free sulfur hydryl group. Ethylene oxide are act by alkylating amino carboxyl hydroxyl and sulfur hydryl group in protein molecules. Quaternary ammonium compounds are act by disruption of cell membrane. Okay, so this is how the various compound are act by various mechanism. Next question is, sputum can be disinfectant by all except देखिए इस तरह के जो क्वेश्चंस होते हैं जहाँ पर कि ऑल एक्सेप्ट पूछा जाता है, तो उस पर भी स्टूडेंट्स को ध्यान देना चाहिए। ऑप्शंस दिए हुए हैं कि ऑटोक्लेविंग, बॉइलिंग, क्रीसोल और क्लोर हेक्सिटीन। सो स्पुटम इज द सब्सटेंस विच इज रिमूव्ड, विच इज रिलीज्ड बाय द पर्सन, इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन, एंड द कॉमनेस्ट पैथोजन्स सस्पेक्टेड टू बी प्रेजेंट इन स्पुटम इज ट्यूबरकुलोई बेसिलाई। सो इट हैज़ टू बी डिसइन्फेक्टेड बाय एन अप्रोप्रिएट टेक्निक, एंड द क्लोरहेक्सिडीन इज अ स्किन एंटीसेप्टिक यूज फॉर बर्न्स एंड और हैंड डिसइन्फेक्टेड, इट इज नॉट अ बैक्टेरिसाइडल। स्पुटम कैन बी डिसइन्फेक्टेड बाय ऑटोक्लेविंग, सो ऑटोक्लेविंग इज द बेस्ट ऑप्शन हीयर। However, some other methods also include like burning of the material. By burning, we can also do the sterilization, and creosol 5% or phenol or boiling through we can also do. But the best ideal option is autoclaving. So the correct answer is autoclaving. Surgical bleed is sterilized by. So such kind of questions are also asked by the examiners in disinfectant chapters, means they in various method they give the examples by autoclave, hot air oven, gamma radiation and steaming. So these are the various methods, and in these methods what type of items are sterilized. So steam is preferred method for sterilization of critical medical and surgical instruments that are not damaged by heat, steam, pressure or moisture. So metal instrument and surgical blade are best sterilized by autoclave. So the answer is autoclave. Next question is hospital dressing is best disposed of by incineration, dumping, autoclaving or burning. So basically infectious non-sharp waste like soiled bandage, dressing, soiled cotton, soiled plaster cast, bedding and other soiled waste first segregated in the rat bags and disposed by autoclaving. So again, autoclaving is the best method for treating infectious waste before disposing. Next question is false about alcohol in disinfections is. So this question is again previously asked in CSIR UGC NET exam. So here examiner are asking what is the false statement about alcohol. So we need to learn the basic about the alcohol. Ethanol is used, isopropyl alcohol is used, has a sporicidal activity, has a bactericidal activity. So now here we are describing about the some fact of the alcohols. Alcohol are most widely used disinfectant and antiseptic. They are bactericidal and fungicidal but not sporicidal, and some lipid containing viruses are also destroyed. Popular alcohol germicides are ethanol and isopropanol, used in 70% concentration. They act by denaturing protein and possibly by dissolving membrane lipid, used as skin antiseptics. And isopropyl alcohol is used for disinfection of clinical thermometers. So here the false statement is has a sporicidal activity. Next question is phenolic disinfectants are. So we have to learn the within disinfectants one of the class is phenolic compounds. So we have to learn all the phenolic compounds, because so many phenolic compounds are used as a disinfectants. Here examiner given the options like Dettol, Cresol, Lysol. So Dettol is like a marketed product. Okay, so all these three are the phenolic compounds. So correct option is all. So various phenolic compounds are like phenol, carbolic acid, chloroxylenol and Dettol 4%, chlorophenol, chloroxyphenol, Lysol 2.5%, Cresol, hexachlorophane 1%, chlorhexidine and Cephalon, that is a marketed product which contains chlorhexidine and cetrimide. Next question is the operating temperatures in ethylene oxide sterilization during a warm cycle is. So this is again a very deep and important questions which is asked in AIIMS exam. So the correct answer is 49 to 63 degrees centigrade. So now learn about some facts about ethylene oxide sterilization. Basically it is a gaseous sterilization and it is active against all kind of bacteria, spores and viruses. It kills all types of microorganisms by inhibiting protein and nucleic acid, highly inflammable and carcinogenic, useful to sterilize disposable plastic petri dishes, sutures, syringes, heart-lung machines, respirators and dental equipments. Next question is, which is a form of cold sterilization? So gamma rays, beta rays, infrared rays and autoclave. So basically ionic radiation like X-ray, gamma ray and beta and cosmic ray are highly lethal to DNA and they have high penetrating power. Since there is no appreciable increase in the temperature in this method, it is called as cold sterilization. So infrared radiation are considered as a hot sterilization. So here the option like gamma rays and beta rays would be the correct answer. Heat liable instruments for use in surgical procedure can be best sterilized by. So absolute alcohol, ultraviolet rays, chlorine releasing compounds, ethylene oxide gas. So here examiner asking the question like heat liable instruments for use in surgical procedure. So ethylene oxide, because ethylene oxide is mainly sporicidal, can and low temperature at 55 degree centigrade it is maintained, hence is a better option among given for the sterilization of heat labile surgical instrument. So the best option is ethylene oxide gas. The rest of the options are not the best suitable options. Next question is again about the instruments. Like chest physician perform bronchoscopy in a procedure room of OPD to make instruments safe for use in the next patient, most appropriate method to disinfect the endoscope is 70% alcohol for 5 minutes, 2% glutaraldehyde for 20 minutes, 2% formaldehyde for 10 minutes and 1% sodium hypochlorite for 15 minutes. So the correct answer is 2% solution of glutaraldehyde is bactericidal, tuberculocidal, sporicidal, fungicidal and pyrocidal. Bacterial spores are destroyed by 2% solution of glutaraldehyde exposure for 3 hours, 2% glutaraldehyde exposure for 20 minutes at 20 degrees centigrade tuberculi bacilli. So this option can also be the correct answer. So it has no deleterious effect on cement and lenses of the instruments such as cystoscopes and bronchoscopes. So student has to learn the scope of the particular sterilization procedure or a disinfectant procedures. Which of the following can be reliably used for hand washing? So generally we always whenever we go to the private hospital, I mean most of the cases in private hospital, on the entry side they put some hand washing bottles. So we have to check the label of these. By this way, in general way, we could learn about the compounds which are included in the hand washing disinfectant. So basically antiseptics are used for hand washing. So chemical disinfectant which can be safely applied on the skin or mucous membrane are used to prevent infection by inhibiting the growth of bacteria, and hence they can be safe used for hand washing. So basically commonly used skin disinfectants are alcohol, halogens and chlorhexidine. So here the options like chlorhexidine and isopropyl alcohol is the correct answer. Which of these will kill spores? Alcohol, phenol, chlorine and aldehyde. So aldehyde are the correct answer because they are able to kill the spores. So sporicidal agents are, we can learn by a simple trick, EFGH. E for ethylene oxide, F for formaldehyde, G for glutaraldehyde and H for hypochlorite, and then H2O2, and then further oxalic acid and parasitic acid, autoclave, hot air oven and plasma sterilization are also the procedure to kill the spores. Next one is sporicidal agents are glutaraldehyde, ethylene oxide, formaldehyde and benzalkonium chloride. So this question is asked in pharmacist recruitment exams. So the correct option is glutaraldehyde, ethylene oxide and formaldehyde. All three options are correct. And what about the benzalkonium chloride? It is a surface active agent and widely used as a wetting agent, detergent and emulsifier. Next question is, chlorinated disinfectant are all except. This question is asked in AIIMS May 2001 exam. So chlorinated disinfectants are, means chloride, where we are using chlorine. So in bleaching powder we are using sodium hypochlorite, we are also using, and halogen tablets we are also using this type of compound, but in citramide it is basically other compound. So we are not using chlorinated disinfectant in citramide. So the correct answer is citramide. Next question is, Cevalone contain. देखिए सेवलोन को हम घरों में भी यूज़ करते हैं और हमारे घर में आता भी है. इट इज़ अ मार्केटेड प्रोडक्ट ब्रांड नेम. एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ, एग्जामिनर आस्किंग व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कंपाउंड इट कंटेन. सो वी शुड रीड द लेबल ऑफ द सेवलोन. जनरली वी आर यूजिंग सेवलोन डेटॉल बट वी आर नॉट रीडिंग द लेबल विच कंपनी मेक दैम एंड विच what are the compound which they contain. So we should make our habit to read the label of those compound which we are taking like tablets, and we are purchasing them for home use. So here the correct option is cetrimide 3% and chlorhexidine 0.3%. both are the compound included in the Cevalone. Next question is, disinfection of water by routine chlorination is classified under sterilization, disinfection, terminal disinfection and pre-current disinfection. So we need to learn various terms like concurrent. What is concurrent disinfections? Basically it is they are applied as soon as the infective material is discharged from the patient, like sputum, feces, vomit, urine and contaminated cloth. So after discharge, these things are discharged from the patient, we need to sterilize or disinfect them. So this is the definition of concurrent disinfection. Precurrent disinfection, they are applied for prior to occurrence of the infection, means chlorination of the water, because whenever we are drinking the water, we need a pure water without infected by any of the microorganisms. So before drinking the water, there is a need of a pre-treatment of the water. So such kind of disinfection is known as a pre-current disinfection. What is terminal disinfection? They are applied after the patient is ceased to be a source of infection, like after that, or discharged from the hospital. Like some people having infection and they discharge from the hospital, so they are the source of the infection. So we need to disinfect them. So such kind of disinfection is known as a terminal disinfection. So in this option, in this question, the pre-current disinfection is the correct answer. Which of the following are used for sterilization of surgical instrument? So again, The options given are ethylene oxide, gamma radiation, autoclaving, glutaraldehyde, and hot air gun. For sterilizing, surgical instruments, most medical and surgical devices are made of materials that are heat stable, and therefore they can be best sterilized by autoclave. So correct option is autoclaving. Again, here I am giving the various methods and like what kind of method is suitable of for what kind of items. So heat labile substance or instrument like plastic can be sterilized by ethylene oxide because these substances are heat labile. They are damaged by high heat. So we need a procedure which is not using high heat to sterilize them. That's why here we are using ethylene oxide or a new low temperature sterilized system like hydrogen peroxide, gas plasma, parasitic acid, immersion and ozone. And dry heat sterilization such as hot air oven should be used only for material that might be damaged by most heat and that are impenetrable to mucus like powder, petroleum products, sharp instruments. Ionization radiations are used. There are no FDA approved ionization radiation sterilization process for use in healthcare facilities. The next question is, all of the following are the tests to check the efficiency of disinfectant except. So this is a very important question because these are the tests to check the efficiency of disinfectants. And like the options given are Chick Martin test, Rieder Walker test, and Hugh Lifson test. So Chick Martin test we are using, Rieder Walker test, also known as a phenol coefficient test, we are using this one. However, Hugh Lifson test is used to differentiate micrococci from streptococci. So this is the different from the two options, and this is the correct answer for this questions.